Hi, need to extract data in a comma-separated file? Okay, we can do that, no problem. This is a new feature in our Summer 20 release, and I will show you how it works. In this case, we want to actually extract all of the opportunities related to our account. Okay, in this case, I admit there are only two opportunities, but we can process really thousands of records in this way. So the extraction is quite good, and the CSV files can be directly used in your BI systems or uploading to any other system that you might use. Cool, let's get started. First of all, we need a data source. We need a data source to select these opportunities. So I already prepared the data source. Everybody knows how to do it. I just used our Sockle Builder, and the Sockle Builder says I need the account, the opportunity, and the name and the amount. So, okay. I'm going to filter on the account in this case, of course, because I want to start from the account, and I want the opportunities related to this account. So I did a where clause, or I made a filter to only select the opportunities related to the account we're currently on. Next, I need a comma-separated file. I need a template. Just like everything in PDF Builder, we actually take the layout of the template that you want, that you decide, and use that to produce the file. Okay, this means that if you want to have a comma point here, or if you want to have a tab here as a separator, that's your decision. You just replace everything with tabs, and that's it. Then you are ready to go. Now, in this case, I decided to go for commas, so I'm going to show you this demo with commas. So I have my CSV file here. As you can see in this one as well, we have all of the merge fields that I need to fill, just as everything in PDF Builder. And one other cool thing is that if you know that certain text fields might also have commas in it, or that they have spaces in it, or anything that you want to escape, you can just put the quotes that you need for your BI systems to upload. You can put these quotes inside the template. So everything how you want it, the output, that it's really under your control. Okay, let's go to a .config. I'm going to create a new one. It's the type comma separated value. So this is the type I need to choose. If this value is not there, make sure that you have access, security access permissions to this record type in the permission set or on your profile. Click next. I'm just going to call this extract all opportunities for account. Okay, I'm going to give this the same name, .csv. Of course, I can put here a placeholder, and like this. And if you want to have a placeholder in the title, you can of course do that. Let's call this the account name, for instance, and I also always put title in it. So we have our account name. Extract, let's call it like this. Okay, cool. So that's our .config. Now I'm going to go to PDF Builder. So opening up the configuration screen. In the configuration screen, I first upload my file, of course. So that's called demo.csv. Yeah, this one over here. I'm going to open it. I'm going to add my data source. I have a lot of data sources, of course. So I'm going to say opportunity, all opportunities from account. That's my data source. So it's built via the Sockle Builder. So it knows perfectly that this is a currency. So everything looks fine here. Next step, creating some config types. Okay, everybody knows how to do this. I just copy the config type here. Yeah, it's of type paragraph, of course, in this case. First of all, I have to identify the row that we are repeating. So then I'm going to put it to a data source. All of the records that we want to show are in this data source. So we are repeating the row that's identified by ID. Okay, merge field is ID, of course, so it can know which row to repeat. And then I'm going to create child data sources to this paragraph. Okay, first up is the ID. Use the parent data source, so use the current record we're in. I'm going to take the ID of our opportunity, and then the merge field is ID. Next one is the name. So now it's just, yeah, always adding these merge fields here. Everything stays the same. So I just take the name here, fill in the merge fields, and then last but not least, the amount. The amount, I have a choice to do some formatting, yeah, currency formatting, but I'm going to upload this file to my BI system, so I don't want to do this formatting. I'm just going to go for no formatting in this case. So it just takes the value as it comes in from Salesforce, yeah, which is formatted as a number, and then that is that's fine. I can process that in my file. Cool. Merge field amount. Looking good. Save. Okay, I must add an alternative name, of course. Let's call it V1, save, and now everything is done. Everything is okay. Next up, I go to my opportunity here. I'm gonna do my account here. I'm gonna do edit page, and I'm gonna add the this doc.config. I'm gonna take the doc.config identifier that's unique over all systems, and I'm gonna use that to put in my doc.config. So I add the components. Let's add it on top. No locale required, no alternative required, just my doc.config. Okay, see, it's already there. Let's save it and test. Okay, click the button so it will take the data, loop through the all of the records, and then I have my my document, of course. Yeah, I currently opened it in, I will open it in, let's see, here it is. I will open it in Notepad++. As you can see, well, this is now my document. All of my two records are there as I assumed. So looking good. Yeah. So yeah, that's actually it. If you want to add a title, yeah, you can just add the title as you please. Just create a data source to select the information from the account. It has to be a single data source for a title, of course, but then you have your full extract as you want it with all of the data that you would expect.